So, you have a movie for me?
Yes, sir, I do. What if Big Monkey punched Big Reptile?
Oh, and vice versa?
Vice versa, too.
Amazing. So how does this thing play out?
Well, during the intro credits, we're gonna show all the monsters that Godzilla and Kong have defeated, right? And that it's all been leading up to this big showdown.
Ah, so these movies have been like a Titan tournament this whole time.
Sure, maybe.
Very cool.
So we're gonna meet this guy, Bernie, who has a conspiracy theory podcast, right? And he works for this big corporation called Apex.
Okay.
And so on his podcast, he's like, well, today's the day. I'm gonna go steal some information from my employers.
And the big corporation has no idea that one of their employees is running a full-on podcast about stealing information from them?
They don't, no. And actually, them having horrible security is gonna be a common thing in this movie.
Oh, how come?
Well, because if they had competent security, that would kind of just slow the movie down, so that's just not gonna be a thing at all.
Fair enough.
Anyway, then for some mysterious reason, Godzilla ends up attacking Apex.
Oh, so Bernie was right. Something weird was going on.
Exactly. I think it's important, especially in this day and age, to, you know, put a positive spin on conspiracy theorists online. Really make them into heroes. Anyway, so because of the attack, people are like, wait, is Godzilla not our savior anymore?
Was he ever the savior? He personally stepped on thousands of people.
Yeah, he's kind of a savior to the people he didn't personally step on.
I guess that makes sense.
So anyway, we're also gonna see Kong, and he's living on Skull Island under 24-hour observation inside that dome from the Hunger Games.
Okay.
And we're gonna find out that all the native humans from Skull Island were killed in a big storm, except for this little deaf girl named Gia, and he has a special bond with her.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, and without anybody knowing, she, like, fully teaches him sign language.
How did she secretly teach a giant monkey sign language while it was under constant supervision?
Unclear.
A very stealthy educator.
So then the obviously evil CEO of Apex approaches this guy, Nathan Lind, who wrote a book about the Hollow Earth theory.
And why is this guy evil?
Oh, well, he secretly wants to make a mecha Godzilla so the humans can defend themselves against Titans.
That's actually a pretty reasonable thing to want.
Yeah, but he's gonna look really evil while he does it, though.
Oh, he is.
Yeah, like he does that thing where he drapes a jacket over his shoulders.
Oh, only evil people do that. Gross.
Exactly. So he wants to send this Nathan guy into the Hollow Earth to find, like, a power source, but they need Kong to guide them.
Why?
Vague reasons that'll drive the plot forward.
Perfect.
So they put Kong on this ship, but then Godzilla's gonna attack, because that's what he does, you know? He attacks other Titans all day.
Sure, of course, he loves to do that.
So they're gonna fight for quite some time, and Godzilla's gonna win.
Oh, wow, 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 wow.
But just as Godzilla's circling around to finish the job, Nathan's gonna tell this captain guy, like, hey, shut everything off, let's play dead.
Okay.
And this guy's like, okay, but this better work.
So he's threatening to hurt Nathan if the plan goes wrong and the lizard kills them all?
Yeah, if Godzilla kills everybody, Nathan's gonna be in big trouble with this guy.
Sounds pretty serious.
So then they're gonna play dead and Godzilla's gonna be like, oh, okay, bye.
Oh, it worked.
It did, but then they're gonna say that as soon as they start moving again, Godzilla's gonna come back and finish the job.
So what do they do?
Well, we're gonna cut to them later and they're carrying Kong in this giant net by air.
Well, how'd they do that without Godzilla noticing?
By being off screen for a little bit.
Oh, Godzilla can't see off screen stuff.
Exactly. So then they head to this Hollow Earth place and they have to go through this big weird wormhole and gravity's all messed up down there. It's crazy.
Does that not hurt them, the sudden change in gravity?
It doesn't, no. Because you know how in 2014 Godzilla technology was pretty much standard military stuff?
Yeah.
Well, now just a couple years later, technology is full-on magic.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, so they have these little magical gravity spaceships that make little blue energy trails. They have tunnels that go from Florida to Hong Kong.
Oh, these movies aren't gonna feel connected at all.
Nope. And so they go around this Hollow Earth place, and Kong feels right at home, and there are a bunch of big monsters there.
Wow, it must be pitch black, too, I imagine.
No, it's like a beautiful sunny day.
Oh, what's the light source?
Unclear.
Oh, okay.
So then Kong is gonna find a throne, and he's gonna find this big axe that's made from another Godzilla's dorsal plate, and this thing freaking glows radioactive blue.
Wow, so okay, we said in another movie that the Titans feed off the intense radiation at the center of the Earth, right?
We did, sure.
And that's where all these humans are hanging out?
That's right.
So, they gonna be okay?
Yeah, sure.
How?
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Oh, okay, I won't.
So anyway, meanwhile, through the movie, we're gonna be checking in with Madison. Remember her from the last movie? She's from the last movie.
She is,
and so she teamed up with a friend and that conspiracy guy, and they're just basically gonna be doing, like, their own little episode of Scooby-Doo.
Oh, they are?
Yeah, they're just kinda wandering around Apex, trying to solve a little mystery, encountering no security whatsoever, and having little to no impact on anything.
Sure, that may as well happen.
And so then back in the Hollow Earth, the Apex space. People are going to send an energy signature back up to Earth, and they're going to use that to power their Mecha Godzilla.
What, so they email a power signature to...
Yeah, listen, sometimes we're just going to say stuff, and it's best not to think about it at all.
But it's just that...
Yeah, we're just going to kind of cut away to monsters punching each other really quickly, so nobody has any time to digest any of the mumbo-jumbo we use as explanations.
Is that going
to
work?
Sure it is. So anyway, Apex is going to use Ghidorah's skulls as a supercomputer to make a psionic uplink and control the Mecha Godzilla telepathically.
Okay, but so
And then monsters are gonna punch each other.
Oh!
Yeah, Godzilla senses that Kong is up to something weird, so he blasts a hole in the Earth all the way down to the hollow Earth area.
What about that weird wormhole section?
Yeah, he blasts through that too, I guess. I don't care. Yeah, sure.
Okay.
And then Kong climbs up the hole.
Does he have to go through the wormhole again?
No,
I'm gonna need you to get all the way off my back about that wormhole. That was several scenes ago. We're done with it.
Oh, okay. Let me get off of that thing.
So then Godzilla and Kong are gonna fight and pretty much destroy Hong Kong.
Oh boy.
Yeah, it's gonna be super intense. They're gonna fight and fight and fight. At a certain point, Godzilla's gonna be like, hehehehe.
What?
And Godzilla's gonna end up defeating King Kong and leaving him for dead.
Oh no.
And meanwhile, that evil CEO guy is gonna be doing like an evil monologue thing, but then Mecha Godzilla's gonna go rogue and crush him.
Oh.
And Bernie's gonna be like, that's unfair. I really wanted to hear the end of that speech.
A man just died in front of his eyes.
Yeah, so he makes a little joke instead of acting like a human person.
Okay.
So now Mechagodzilla is being controlled by the ghost of Ghidorah or something? I don't care. It's gonna look great.
Sure, I bet.
And Godzilla could really use Kong's help, so the humans want to stop him from dying.
Oh man, it's gonna be tough for tiny humans to do that.
Actually, it's gonna be super easy. Barely an inconvenience.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Nathan's gonna be like, hey, maybe I could use that magical ship we've been flying around in as a defibrillator on this giant monkey.
Oh wow, okay, so this guy's like pretty experienced with this ship, huh?
He literally just learned it existed.
And he knows how to use it to restart a giant monkey's heart?
Sure, yeah, I don't care.
And now that Kong isn't dead, he and Godzilla can team up against a common threat, which is what you have to do when your movie has Versus in the title.
Oh, double teaming a robot is tight. So then they manage to defeat Mechagodzilla through the power of teamwork.
Wow, wow, wow. Wow.
And so then Godzilla's like, okay, bye, and Kong goes to live in Hollow Earth, and that's it, we're done.
Wow, really rushing to that ending, huh?
Well, we're done with the punching, so, you know, what's the point?
That makes sense.
And so, yeah, what do you think?
Well, I mean, it's a movie where a giant monkey gets in a fight with a giant reptile, you know? What could go wrong?
Hey everybody, Ryan here. Hope you enjoyed that video. And if you liked it, feel free to click the like button and the subscribe button and all, you know, buttons of that nature. There are also like hundreds of other episodes on the channel that you can check out if you want. Also leave a comment down below letting me know what other movies you want to see pitches for. And check back soon for a new one, because there's gonna be new ones, you know? Okay, bye.